are
it's
you?
It's like a legal wall. Yeah.
Mexico has a big graffiti culture, especially the Mexicans up in California, etc. And it fitted perfectly with our bar and so everything. We're a big tequila bar and Mexican culture, so everything fitted in perfectly. All the graffiti in there is themed either Dia de los Muertos, which is a Mexican Day of the Dead celebration, and upstairs all the graffiti you see is actually these, the three pillars that you filmed are actually special boxes that some specific type of tequila comes in. So every year they change the box. It's a different Mexican artist, so I had somebody replicate that. A guy, a well-known artist in London called Kaiser One. So he came and did all our graffiti for us.
Get a scoop later.
Let's go.
Is there a specific graffiti designer that you like?
Well, Josh Cole, before, and I really admire the way he's kind of taken life experiences and obviously turned it into his work and stuff, which I really like.
Okay, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Sing along, everybody now!
Well, I have got a lot of friends who have been graffiti artists for many years, so I have a positive view of graffiti, I think.
Okay.
The draconian penalties in Britain today for graffiti are absolutely abhorrent. We are the only European country who incarcerates young people for committing the crime of graffiti. In all other European countries, the maximum you can receive is a community sentence. I think very negative to send young men whose only crime is painting pictures. I think it's very negative to put them into prison with people who've committed serious violent crimes, drug-related crimes.
You got a $20 bill, get your hands up!
No, I think that there's a very wide range of types of graffiti, from highly stylized pieces that are big, colourful, and take hours to perform, right the way down, and then you have your you have dubs and bones, which are the very simple throw-ups of usually two colours, black and chrome, which people can put up very simply, but are big, usually bubble forms of writing, right the way down to the tag, which is very simple and you can put it up very simply. I think tags are a piece of art. People spend a long time working on them, making sure that they can create an image that they can A, put up very quickly, and is B, stylized and beautiful. You could argue that some people's tags aren't very beautiful, or that some pieces of graffiti aren't very beautiful, but there are some pieces of art, some artists do pieces of work that are not beautiful. It doesn't mean they're not art. You might say it's rubbish art, but it doesn't mean it's not. But you cannot say it is not art, in my opinion.
Okay.
Can I get up? Can I get up?
I think that graffiti can be seen to destroy the urban environment in the sense that there is a collection of images put onto, say, a wall or a surface or a vehicle that is unorganized, and the artists will layer images over one another, and the artists often think little about the placing of their piece of art. The most important thing for them is that it is up somewhere, so they will draw it over someone else's, even if it doesn't look very good for the viewer. All they care about is getting it up. So I can see that some people see graffiti as destroying the urban environment in those senses. And I do understand that people who are not very well practiced at graffiti, their tags and their very simple drawings are, as I said earlier, I don't think they're not art, but they're just not very good pieces of art. And if there's a lot of that, then it can be frustrating and you can think that the area looks ugly. I think that there are cases in which graffiti does improve the urban environment. In particular, the bigger pieces that people have spent a lot of time on, they've put a lot of colour into. And I think in certain areas, I prefer walls with a piece of graffiti on. If I walk down a street and I see a beautiful, what I consider to be beautiful wall because it's old, say you have a Georgian wall, it's hundreds of years old, then I would rather that wall stays as it is. However, if I walk down the street and there's a concrete wall, then that was thrown up in the past 10 years, as far as I'm concerned, it's probably better if someone bothers to paint something on top of that concrete wall. However, they do need to spend some time on it, and it does need to be nice.
Okay. Do you think that there should be penalties for political graffiti, or do you think that political graffiti is an important expression of freedom?
It's really interesting, isn't it? Because there's a big there seems in the public's perception, there's a big difference between political graffiti and gang graffiti. I think that most people feel that political graffiti is in some way acceptable. I think mostly because it's done by middle class people. Traditional graffiti, where mostly young men write four letter words that is their pseudonym, is all about saying, me, look at my painting, I drew whatever it is, Edward, I drew Edward all over the city. And I think that, and that form of graffiti is associated with a type of gang culture, crews. As opposed to the sort of Banksy-style political graffiti, done mostly by middle-class people, and it's often done, it's a different type of art form because it usually uses different techniques, so it uses stencils. You are advertised soaked society. We are so inundated by images every single day that actually graffiti is an individual's way of responding to the fact that there are so many images around, and individuals have thought, I want to do my own art. If when I walk down the road, I have to see 37 images by Ford, McDonald's, Honda, whoever it is, then I want to make this road mine, actually. It is my communal space, and I have the right, therefore, to adorn it just as it's being adorned by companies. And in that respect, well, I think that's the strongest argument against the argument that you should not be allowed to paint over things that do not belong to you.
What up? Yo, SP.
So hold me ever get seen in my life.
This one's for Queens.
Y'all me one for the squeeze.
This one's for Brooklyn.
Put me thing right around
New York City.
Y'all give me the practice. Hold me ever get seen in my life.